let's get it on. Yeah, y'all can come along. Everybody drinks on me, bought out the bar just to feel like I'm a star. Now I'm thanking the Academy. Missed my ride home, lost my iPhone. I wouldn't have it any other way. If it were me, let me hear you say,
I like it like that. Hey, windows down, chilling with the radio on. I like it like that. Damn, sun's so hot. Make the girls take it all off. I like it like that. Yeah, one more time. I can never get enough. Oh, everybody, sing it right back. I like it like that.
I like it like that.
Till the break of dawn, yeah. Party on the lawn. Whistle as the girls walk by. If the cops roll up, pour the cops a cup, 'cause everybody's here tonight. Call a taxi, pack the backseat. I wouldn't have it any other way. If you're with me, let me hear you.
So the classes came about because with the mongrel training, the girls really like it, but they were too scared to do it because the boys are obviously really big and really fit, and it was quite intimidating. So what happened was I said to Shane that I thought that we should start a girls class so they can do the same sort of training but not have the intimidation with it. So we did it, and we posted it on Facebook and got some people coming. That was nearly 3 months ago. So on our first class, I think we had maybe about 12 girls. And now we have about 20, Megan and Amy there. And so now we have about 20, it's a wee bit more than that. And there's no contracts or anything like that. People just pay $10 a time, and they can choose when they want to come. If they don't want to come, that's fine. And it's just taken off, and the girls love it. At first, we were really nice, and we didn't push them too hard, and they kind of just messed around. And as time's progressed and I've got fitter, we've really started pushing them now, and there's a bit of yelling that goes on and a few swear words every now and again, especially to Shane. So that's been cool. And as it's even got bigger, the girls have asked for a second class, so that's really cool. So what we're going to do is start another one on Saturdays and have the two classes going. And yeah.
Well done, you.
Right.
Yeah.
Now next what? Question.
Yep.
Hi, I'm Megan and I'm training with Powtech, CJ and Shane though, not just Shane. Well, I don't like being a fatty, so that was, I just want to be able to run around with my kids and do whatever they want to do without being like, oh, I'm the fat mum. Before I had Tia, who's 9, I was like 60 kilos, and then I had her, and then I just put on a lot, and I got, I think, to about 85 after I had her, and then I didn't really care. I was just like, meh, whatever. And then after I had Tessa, I put on more again. And then I lost it, and I put it back on again. So, yeah, it's just been an ongoing battle, I guess, since I had Tia. I'm a mum, and I work full-time. Start at 7 in the morning, go till 2 in the afternoon, normally. And then I go home, and I probably go home for about 10 minutes, and I've got to pick up Tessa from school. Then I've got to pick up Tia from kindy, and then, no, Tessa from kindy, Tia from school. And then I've got to come home and cook for my husband because he works full time. So we both work full time. And then sometimes if I get a chance before tea, I go to the gym. Or if I can't do it before tea, then I go after tea. But make sure I go 6 days. So Friday's my day off. And yeah, I'm very busy, but I still manage to get it in there, get time to go. Well, I started doing the women's training with CJ and Shane on a Wednesday night. And then they were offering up gym memberships, you know, join the gym, blah, blah, blah. So I joined the gym, and I was sort of like, you know, because I complain a lot. Like, I hate exercising, but I'm getting used to it, and I'm starting to maybe enjoy it, but don't tell them that. But yeah, I'm doing the training with them on a Wednesday, and then on a Saturday I'm doing boxing with the two Dans. And CJ's made a diet for me to follow, and yeah, I'm following that and doing really well. So it was 110.8 kilos, and now I'm 100. What am I? I'm 100.4 kilos now.
Mm. Yes. Yeah. And that's since.
That's how many weeks have we? Nine weeks. In 9 weeks, yeah.
Jeez.
It's slowing down now, but it'll. I'm trying to do, you know, like I'm trying to maybe start going for walks in the morning before work, even though I start at 7. I'll be really tired. time. But I'm going to maybe start trying to go for a walk in the morning and maybe step it up a bit and do a wee bit more to try and lose more. But I don't want to lose it too fast.
You want to keep it off?
Yeah, I do want to keep it off because I did another diet a few years ago and I lost 25 kilos in 4 months, but straight away put it straight back on. I think it took me a month to put it back on. It didn't take very long at all. I could just look at food and put it back on. So I need to keep it off this time because I can't carry on the way I am. Well, Shane wants me to get to 95 kilos before, at the end of May. I'm just doing small goals because that's more realistic for me, I guess. But ideally, I would like to get maybe to 70 kilos, in between 70 and 75.
So a lot of the women that come, not all of them, but the majority are actually mothers and they're at home and they really struggle to get out and exercise and just have time for themselves. So as they came, they started making new friends and the groups actually become really close that everyone came to my hen's night and we're planning another girls' night out just together so everyone can get together and have fun and not only train together but have these friendships. A part of the class is that you can work to your own sort of fitness level, so if one person's really fit and the other person's not, I mean, we know where everybody's at, so we know when not to push people too hard. But I think one of the benefits from it is that people get time out from their families because we do need it, and you get your friends and training, so it's kind of, it's an all-rounder.
What was it? 6 and 7?
Six.
It's not too bad.